Today we're going to discuss strategies for tackling the MCAT CARS section, also known as the Critical Analysis and Reasoning Skills section. Many students find the CARS section to be the hardest section of the MCAT. Additionally, many students will score very highly in the science sections, only to have their overall score dragged down by a low CARS score. Worse, this is totally avoidable if you approach your CARS prep the right way. I'm Vikram Shah, MCAT expert and 528 MCAT scorer. In this video, we will go over a general overview of the MCAT CARS section, plus 9 different passage study strategies you can use to maximize your score. I'll teach you step by step how to approach difficult CARS passages, how to change up your MCAT CARS strategy if you don't see improvement, and how to review your practice passages to get the most out of your practice. Let's get started. What does the CARS section of the MCAT look like? The MCAT CARS section is designed to test your reading comprehension and critical thinking skills. The MCAT CARS contains a slightly different format than the chemistry, physics, biology, biochemistry, and psychology, sociology sections of the exam. The other sections contain 59 questions each, which you must complete in 95 minutes. On the CARS section, you have 90 minutes to answer 53 questions based on 10 passages. Another big difference is that there are no standalone questions on the CARS section of the exam. According to the MCAT test developers at the AAMC, 50% of CARS passages will be humanities-based, while the other 50% come from the social sciences. This does not mean you have to remember history facts that you might have learned in college. In fact, you won't be required to bring in any outside information to score well on the CARS section. Humanities passages may include topics such as literature, art, dance, ethics, popular culture, and theater, among others. Social sciences, on the other hand, include passages on topics such as economics, education, history, geography, political science, psychology, and sociology. The AAMC, however, is not testing your knowledge about a particular subject, but rather your ability to reason through an author's argument and answer questions about a passage in a short period of time. Now that we've covered the general overview of the MCAT CARS section, let's dive into 9 study strategies you can try in order to improve your CARS score. Note that you may have to try different strategies or even a combination of these strategies before you find something that actually works. MCAT CARS strategy number 1. Focus on the main idea. The AAMC likes to introduce complex passages with several ideas. For example, a passage may give us the author's opinion, the opinion of someone who agrees with the author, and the opinion of someone who disagrees with the author. In this strategy, write down the big picture points from each paragraph on the sheet of paper provided to you during the exam. You should use symbols, arrows, or shorthand notation in order to jot down this main idea more quickly. Very few people end up referring back to the passage outline when they answer questions, but the goal of the strategy is to encourage active reading. In other words, if you know that you have to write something down at the end of the paragraph you are reading, you will try to synthesize the information as you move through it and weed out the unnecessary info. A common pitfall of this strategy is that students spend too much time writing things down. Remember, the process of outlining the passage should not take so much time that it prevents you from having enough time to answer the passage's questions. Whether or not you decide to outline each paragraph of the passage, you should spend some time at the end of the passage doing 2 things. Identify both the main idea and the tone of the passage. This is the most important step of this strategy. To identify the author's main idea, ask yourself, what is the takeaway point from this entire passage? To identify the author's tone, ask yourself, how does the author feel about the subject discussed in the passage? If you're able to identify the main idea and tone successfully, you'll be able to correctly answer questions on the MCAT CARS section. MCAT CARS strategy number 2. Predict the next paragraph. In this strategy, you start by reading the first paragraph. Then, before reading the second paragraph, you make an educated guess about what the next paragraph is going to be about. For example, if the first paragraph introduced a famous Greek poet, the second paragraph might introduce another famous Greek poet, talk about an example of the poet's works, or criticize the poet's work. The important part of the strategy is not making the right prediction, but it is rather recognizing whether or not your prediction was right. Let's look at the difference between those two. The first is a guess, while the second tests your reading comprehension. By working through passages using this exercise, you will find yourself grasping the author's trail of logic more easily, which will help you answer both big picture and detail-oriented questions. If you find yourself having trouble sticking to the strategy, cover up the next paragraph with a piece of paper to prevent peeking. MCAT CARS strategy number 3, classify each sentence. MCAT CARS passages are often confusing as several ideas may be introduced and the author's argument might be hard to follow. This strategy helps you to decode these passages that the CARS section likes to throw at you. In this strategy, you classify each sentence of a paragraph as a topic sentence, the sentence introducing the main idea of the paragraph, an example, a sentence that supports the main idea of the paragraph with concrete evidence, an explanation, a sentence that supports the main idea of the paragraph without necessarily having concrete evidence, a side note, something related to the main idea of the paragraph but not essential, a new idea. CARS passages often introduce competing ideas, and this is a new idea within a paragraph. Extra information, something that is not necessary to the main idea of the paragraph. Once you start classifying sentences this way, you'll be able to wade through the murky waters of CARS passages to find the important information needed to answer questions. Try this strategy on a few untimed passages to get a feel for its use. It doesn't have to be a strategy that you always use, but it is a helpful exercise to gain perspective on the anatomy of CARS passages, especially if you are in a rut or score plateau for the CARS section. MCAT CARS strategy number 4, finish passages quickly. A lot of students notice that they do the best on the CARS passages at the end of the section when they've almost run out of time. That seems counterintuitive, but there's an explanation for this. Under extreme time pressure, you are forced to focus on the big picture and main ideas of the passage without getting lost in the small details. By focusing on the big picture, as is recommended in strategy number 1, you will get more questions right and be less susceptible to trap answers. To apply this strategy, try taking a few passages timed at 8 or 9 minutes. Remember, the normal time for a CARS passage is 10 minutes. This will force you to read quickly, maybe even skim some sections, so that you have enough time to answer the questions. If this doesn't work for you, we can try the opposite approach in strategy number 5. Just to reiterate, I've said it and I'll say it once more, every strategy doesn't work for every person. Try a strategy a few times to get a feel for it, and if it doesn't fit your thinking style, move on to another. MCAT CARS strategy number 5. Take more time on passages. Pretend you sit down to take your CARS section, but the MCAT gives you the option of unlimited time. That's right, you have as much time as you want to try and get the questions correct. Would you select this option? This strategy emphasizes untimed practice and gives you a chance to reason through harder passages while applying any of the other strategies, except strategy 4, of course. The benefit of untimed practice is you will be able to better identify your weaknesses by tracking how much time you spend on certain questions or aspects of answering questions. MCAT CARS strategy number 6. Look for text evidence. If you look at the answer key for nearly every AAMC CARS question, there is one thing in common. They all refer back to a piece of text evidence. They have to do this in order to make sure that their answers are 100% correct. Use this piece of information to your advantage. Knowing this makes our job much easier. We know that the support for the correct answer is somewhere in the passage. We just have to find the text evidence that supports it. So, in this strategy, you don't highlight anything from the passage as you read through it. Instead, in order to mark an answer to one of the questions, you have to highlight the text evidence from the passage that you are using to support your answer choice. Then, during your test review, check to see how closely your highlights align with the text evidence provided by the answer key. For example, let's say the text of a passage reads, "Throughout history, people have cultivated and grown various forms of plants for self-sustenance. Some historians believe that there was a discrete transition from a hunter-gatherer population to an agricultural population, although genetic evidence shows that the two populations may have coexisted." Rather than classify the populations based on the two categories, which is unnecessarily restrictive, it is possible and likely that hunters also farmed and farmers also hunted. Now, let's say this is the question we get. Which of the following viewpoints does the author most likely agree with? A. The transition from an agricultural population to a service-oriented population has only begun in recent years. B. A more appropriate method of classification might be a spectrum on which hunter-gatherer only and agriculture only represent the extremes. C. Populations practicing only agriculture may have existed far before a need for hunter-gatherers arose. And D. The genetic evidence is unsubstantiated and is likely a result of specimen contamination. Now let's see how this text evidence strategy works for us. The question is asking us to determine what the author agrees with, so we must first determine what the author thinks. which sentence contains the author's viewpoint, the first, second, or third? If you said the third sentence, you are correct. Though the author never explicitly states that this is what he or she believes, the words unnecessarily restrictive indicate that the author disagrees with both the discrete transition theory and the coexistence theory. Let's look at answer choice A. The transition from an agricultural population to a service-oriented population has only begun in recent years. Is there any text evidence supporting a service-oriented population in recent years? No, service is not mentioned once in the passage. Answer choice B says, a more appropriate method of classification might be a spectrum on which hunter-gatherer only and agriculture only represent the extremes. Can we highlight a sentence that supports this? Yes, we can highlight sentence 3, which shows that the author believes there is some sort of happy medium. Therefore, choice B is correct. As an exercise, walk through choices C and D and demonstrate to yourself why a lack of text evidence indicates that they are incorrect answer choices. Try this strategy on a few untimed passages to see how well it works for you. This is another great strategy many students have success with, especially if they are in a CARS rut. MCAT CARS strategy number 7, create an example passage. In this strategy, begin by taking a CARS passage using any of the other available strategies. Now, read through the answer choices and explanations. Reset the passage and with the right answers in mind, go through the passage again, this time highlighting any and all information in the passage or question that would have helped you get the questions right the first time around. So, if you missed a key piece of text evidence that helped answer one of the questions, highlight it. If you missed the least likely in the question stem and therefore missed the question, go ahead and highlight that part of the question stem. Now, once you've gone through the entire passage again, you have an example passage or a passage that you've approached perfectly. Do this for a few passages ranging from easy to medium to hard. At the end, you should have a handful of passages that you can refer back to and see how you answered specific types of questions. MCAT CARS strategy number 8, read the questions first. In this strategy, you click through the questions before you read the passage. While doing so, you write down any key paragraphs or bits of information that you should be looking for while you read. For example, if one question refers to paragraph 4, make sure you understand paragraph 4 once you start reading, in addition to how paragraph 4 fits in with the rest of the passage. The benefit of this strategy is that you will be able to guide your focus while reading the passage on topics or paragraphs that are directly referred to in the questions. The one pitfall of this strategy, which can be avoided by making sure you don't look at the answer choices of the questions, is that seeing a misleading answer choice can affect your reading or interpretation of the passage. MCAT CARS strategy number 9, challenge reading and vocabulary. You are not alone if you struggle through MCAT CARS passages covering philosophy or literature. If you identify reading comprehension as the limiting aspect of your CARS section, this strategy is helpful. It is only helpful, however, if you are strongly committed to spending 20 to 30 minutes every day reading good material, in addition to a few extra minutes making sure you understand exactly what you are reading. In addition to reading comprehension, many students find themselves missing questions because they did not know the vocab. While some vocab words can be determined from context clues, it never hurts to build your vocabulary for the MCAT CARS section. Whenever you encounter a new vocab word while taking CARS practice, write it down with its definition, make flashcards, and study them. By now, we have covered the general overview of the MCAT CARS section, and you have a toolbox of study strategies to attack your practice problems and increase your MCAT CARS score. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos. And if you'd like to receive a free MCAT question of the day so that you can get in every last bit of practice before test day, click the link in the description. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.